Hi, welcome to this video tutorial about implementing a custom use case in a Flutter project by bridging native iOS code. PSPDFKit's Flutter wrapper aims to expose a lot of our framework's APIs to Dart. These APIs allow you to implement simple use cases in Flutter very easily. We have also aimed to keep our Flutter plugin quite extensible to allow users to bridge native Objective-C code, which enables the plugin to adapt to more complicated use cases. In the PSPDFKit Flutter wrapper, we expose two different components in Dart. The first one is the PSPDFKit view component that you can see in this file PSPDFKit_view.dart. The second component is the PSPDFKit global plugin, which can be found in this file main.dart. Let us see an example of how these can be used. The PSPDFKit view component allows you to embed PSPDFKit functionality into Flutter's navigation hierarchy, like we see in this simple example here. We can also show two PDFs on the same page, like this. On the other hand, the PSPDFKit global plugin is useful when trying to show a PDF file modally. Depending on your project's requirements, you can use one or the other. In our companion blog post to this video, we have described both of these components in more detail. Although it's not necessary to know everything about the internals, it certainly helps when trying to adapt the Flutter plugin for more complex use cases. Before we get started, I'll be assuming that you are familiar with Flutter and that you have already integrated PSPDFKit into your project. Otherwise, you can use our example project, which is bundled inside the Flutter open source repo. In this tutorial, I'll be using this same example project to demonstrate how to extend the plugin by bridging Objective-C code. So let's get started then. What we want to do is to add a custom button to the annotation toolbar that enables us to delete all the annotations from a PDF file. We already have this exact example in our catalog project that can be found in the DMG with our native framework. Let's take a look at the Objective-C code in this example. You can find it by searching for PSC annotation toolbar example in the search bar. So in this example, we are creating a custom toolbar subclass which adds a clear button with a trash can icon that will delete all the annotations from the PDF. We don't need to go into detail into the Objective-C implementation for the purpose of this video tutorial, but you can take a look at the example to get a better idea of how we are implementing this feature. Let's run the example. Here, I'm drawing a bunch of ink annotations. And as we can see, there is a trash can icon, which when clicked, deletes all of them. Now, if we look at the Flutter examples, we don't have the trash can button in the annotation toolbar by default. So let's go ahead and add it. So back in our Flutter example, let's go to the PSPDF platform view.m file. In this, we need to add the custom annotation toolbar that we saw from the catalog example earlier. So let's go ahead and copy the implementation and the interface. We take the interface and we'll copy it put it at the very top of the file. For the implementation, we'll copy it again and paste it right at the bottom of this file. Now let's try running the example and see if this made any difference. As you can see, there's still no trash can button on the annotation toolbar. That's because we haven't told the PSPDFKit framework to use our custom annotation toolbar yet. So let's do that. Here in the handle method call function, we create new platform views when we receive the initialized platform view call from Flutter. we will need to update the configuration object of PSPDF view controller to tell it to use the custom annotation toolbar that we just created. Here's how to do it. In this line, we are telling the framework to use the custom PSC custom button annotation toolbar class that we just created instead of the default PSPDF annotation toolbar class. Now let's try running the example again to see if it made any difference. As you can see, the delete button is visible now. We can try adding some annotations. And when we tap on the delete button, all of those will be deleted. I hope that this tutorial helped you get a better understanding of how to bridge Objective-C code to Dart so you can implement more complex use cases in your Flutter app. Thanks for watching.